With pivot tables, the ideal is to have a nice clean database to include in your pivot table. But it's not always possible to have a nice database like this. So here's a very simple example where I have a number of items all over the place that represent a form of a database. You'll see I've got a few more here. We need to include them in a pivot table and basically give us the ability to consolidate them. In order to do this, you can use something called multiple consolidation ranges. In Excel 2007, it has become a little bit harder to find the multiple consolidation ranges item. In order to do it, you must hold down your Alt key, click your D key, and then click your P key. And the old pivot table wizard will appear. And you'll see it asks for where is the data, is it a list, an external data source, or multiple consolidation ranges. This is the one we want, we'll click on it, we can say next. You'll see it says you can create a pivot table that uses ranges from one or more worksheets. The question it's going to ask you is how many page fields do you want? Now it's important to understand this. What we have here is a summary, and these two places are in a place called Gauteng, and this is Natal. So at some point I want to be able to differentiate all the items that belong to one province versus all the items that belong to another province. And I know there's only two provinces here. So I want two page fields. You'll see the option is to create a single page field, or else you can say you're going to create the page fields. I'm going to say next, I will create the page fields. You've now got this toolbar and we're going to work through it. The first thing we need to do is specify how many page fields we want. And because I know there's two provinces, I'm going to click on the two, and you'll see immediately field one and field two is open for us. The next thing to realize is it's quite a powerful tool in the sense that if you look closely, you'll see that the databases are slightly different. This one has got fuel, oil, and shop. This has got fuel, oil, shop, and car wash. And this is back to fuel, oil, shop. And even the order doesn't really matter. So all we need to do is we click in the range and we highlight the entire area. Okay. I'm just going to add it. But I need to then tell it, where does this range fit? Is it field 1 or otherwise province 1? Or field 2, province 2. So I'm going to say this item called Ravonia belongs in field 1. Okay. So now we've set up and we've told it that this range is in field 1 called Ravonia. I can now go and identify another range. In this case, this area here. I'm going to add it. By default, it stays on this one, but I'm going to go here and say, no, please change that to the word Benoni, the title here, because I know that Benoni is also in province 1. So now if I click on the first one, you'll see that's Ravonia, that's Benoni. Let's add a third one, and this is going to be Durban. I'm going to add it. In this case, I know Durban is not part of this province, but rather part of that province. So for this one, I'm going to delete Benoni and put Durban in field 2. So now it's Ravonia, that's Benoni, that's Durban. We can keep going. So on the second sheet, I have a few more items. Got something called Pinetown. Okay, I'm going to highlight it, add it. Pinetown I know belongs to this province as well. So I'm going to put it into Pinetown. Just check that they're still aligned. Let's go onto the sheet. I'm going to highlight Brakpan. I'm going to add it. Brakpan I know belongs to the first province. So I'm going to remove Pinetown here. Go put it back into Okay, we're going to add one more. Gonna highlight that. We're going to add this one here called PMB. Add it. And I know that PMB belongs to province 2, to Natal. Delete that. We'll call it PMB. Let's just check that everything looks like it's in sync. Perfect. We can go next. We're now asked where we want to place the pivot table. So either in the existing worksheet or in a new worksheet. I'm going to put it in a new worksheet. I'm going to say finish. And what you'll see, it creates a pivot table. And notice that page 1 and page 2, if I click on page 1, and remember I had the field 1, province 1, there's my Benoni, Brakpan, Rivonia. Page 2, Durban, Pinetown, PMB. So I can actually change these names. This I know is a province called Gauteng, and this here is Natal. The pivot table itself, you'll see, has pulled all the information through. We may just need to reorder it. So I'm going to put my sales back to the top. But then it goes cost of sales. There's a gross profit. And in this case, we don't need the grand total. So I'm just going to go to the pivot table options and just remove the grand total for rows and the grand total for columns. And now we've got is a very quick pivot table which has consolidated all those details. If, for example, I just want to see what's happening in Benoni, I switch Benoni on there, go to Natal and say please show me the blanks there, and you'll see these numbers will correspond to these numbers. So 2018-2, 2018-2 for fuel. There's the fuel. So you can now take multiple ranges and consolidate them into one pivot table. And from there you can use your normal pivot table features and functions.